What's up, everybody? It's your boy CJ, and it takes me to play these games. And we're back with, I can't believe I forgot the name of this game. Last stop. Last time we started off with Paper Dolls, and we ended it with Stranger Danger. This time we're going to start off with Domestic Affairs, and then we're going to end it with Paper Dolls. Should I start putting these all together, or should I just keep them separate? Let me know in the comments if you guys want to see it separate.
Previously on Last Stop.
You're Wendy, right?
I like your wedding ring.
Did you tell your daughter I'm married?
I don't keep secrets from her. She's a grown-up girl.
Hey, Dad.
I mean, you shouldn't even be messing around with another man when you're married.
Spider. Very easy to find.
We doing business or what?
No more dealing. You're done.
You've got bare bad things coming your way.
Bare bad things. Big bad things. Oh, before I continue, hold on. I need to go do
That was good.
She always really tapping this man out.
I can't do this again.
You goddamn right, you got a family. Moment.
I didn't mean right this second.
You're feeling guilty.
I'm married. I shouldn't be doing this. It's not right.
At least talk to your husband about it and get an open marriage. Mean? Always short term, nothing to explain, don't be soft. Always short term.
You didn't really think this was going anywhere, did you?
So is that it?
No, Paul. I'm making her a bitch, but I also want to make her feel sad. Late for your husband.
I'm late for an appointment.
Okay, well, can I meet you for a coffee sometime? I don't know. This all seems a bit rushed.
Don't answer that. Get the hint. Get the hint,
bro.
I'll
send you a text or something. Gotta run.
Listen, bro. She don't like you. She's just trying to get away from her husband. She feels like she's trapped. That's why she's over here complaining, because she's like, oh, I'm going to be with one person the entire time. Then why get married? At least talk to your husband about it. It was fun while it lasted. Sure, I can't tempt you into a coffee. Block, ghost him, say something nice. Block him. You're about your family. You're about your family right now. Goddamn right. As me to block an annoying instant messenger chat. Nah, she about to be about her family over with me controlling her. God damn it. We don't do tears around here. Oh, snap. God, I'm allergic to bullshit. I'm a bit late pretending that you're wrong. This is a chore. I'm a bit late.
Okay, how are we doing? Am I late?
Yeah, by like 20 minutes. An apology would be nice.
Sorry.
Work.
Come on, let's go in.
I want to admit that she's cheating. I really do.
Hello, Dan. Mrs. Hughes. It's lovely to have a chance to talk to you both at last. It was getting late. I'd assumed you weren't coming.
I'm so
Oh my god, that's Donna's mom. She's a teacher. How's Dylan?
How's Dylan doing, Mrs. Adeleke, is it?
Tamara, please.
Look at the connections of all these stories.
This is my wife, Mina.
Pleased to meet you, Mina. Dylan's progress this term has been good. He's blossoming it into quite the artist.
I can't believe some of the stuff he brings back from school.
Hold
Sorry,
on, I think I
got
this.
Take this.
Mina, don't you think you could do this afterwards?
I have an interesting opportunity.
Really
it's quite all right.
Hold on. I don't know why you answered that phone call like that. I heard
okay, what were we talking about?
Well... As I was saying, Dylan has a keen interest in drawing.
Sorry, that's me again.
Girl, if you don't put that on silent...
I'm really sorry about this.
It's fine. You two continue.
Well, I've never been so embarrassed.
My fault. Here it comes. He's not overreacting. You were in the middle of talking about your son. Here
Is this where I can expect the big lecture on why I'm such a bad parent?
Oh, damn,
you're
I was
not
a
bad parent, Mina. You're just... You're never here to do any of it. When you are, I feel like you'd rather be somewhere else.
He wanted this. It's my job. Not this again. What's the less bitchiest response? Okay, it's my job.
For Christ's sake, Dan. It's my job. What do you want me to do? Quit and become what? A teacher? You think we can afford to live in that house on two teachers' salaries?
Oh my god, this is terrible.
Get real, Dan. I'm providing for this family.
Oh my god, no, she didn't.
I'm not asking for the world. I just want some extra help.
I'm off. You can continue this on the way home if you want.
But you're the one cheating, though. Why are you getting angry? See, now I'm getting mad for Dan. This makes no sense.
I tried calling the office earlier. They said you'd left for the day.
Oh, she's getting caught. Hold on.
Well, I don't know why they'd say that.
Oh, God damn it. I was moving my laptop.
Brilliant.
Let's hear it.
I feel like you want to ask something.
What's the point? You've always got an excuse.
Ooh, okay. This marriage is on the rocks. This marriage is on the rocks. She got the same bra and panties on. If you don't change it up a little bit... Nothing but suits and suits and suits in here. What was I wearing last time? Let's put on the light gray.
Can we go out?
Eat your muesli.
Am I moving?
Then oh, no, she can is. Can we go out?
No promises. Not till that bowl is empty.
Hold on.
Even the gray bits.
Especially Dylan, the gray bits.
Dylan kind of dark skinned it. And Felix is dark skinned too.
Bring out the choo-choo train.
Did you cheat on your husband when you were pregnant?
Well, maybe Mum would like to take you.
Okay.
Would you like that, Dylan?
Yeah.
Oh, God. Come on, get dressed.
Get dressed, troublemaker.
Thanks, Mina.
Right, so this is the time with your son.
Can I go on the swings?
Bro, what am I looking at? Of course.
Of course.
Bro, what is...
Mina Hughes, this is Harlequin. Please authenticate.
Am I supposed to
Hughes
tap it?
Hughes 47 Alpha Tango.
What?
What's up?
Why does he have that hat on his head? I'm so confused.
For your authorization on the Munich document.
And his hat's gone.
He's saying you must have forgotten.
Can I have some ice cream? I can't send it off without someone's signature. Tell Amrit he can authorize this himself. He should know. I explained this to him on Wednesday.
I ain't stopping. I'm not stopping. Voicemail.
We need this out today.
Mom!
Just you going to tell your son to hang up?
Look, forget
I mean,
it.
Shut up.
I'll come by the office.
What type of mother are you?
How about we get you home so you can watch some TV?
But we only just got here.
Right, Mom. Another time.
We can go to the park another time. I have to go to work.
I'm trying to spin even faster. Come on.
You always say that. Fine, let's go then.
I know he's dizzy out of his mind.
Are you mad with me?
What even is your job?
Getting dick down.
Something to do with lying to people.
Okay, I gotta stop. Yep, she's always lying. Pretty sharp.
It's not entirely incorrect.
You're always lying to your husband.
What is it?
When he's older.
You're too young to understand.
Why can't you just tell me?
Because she's cheating on your dad and also at the same time getting pushed away for a younger woman. Alright.
Fine. I work for a British private military security and intelligence company.
MI6.
My job is to monitor, support, and execute orders for our investigators out in the field.
Bro, this
the data
is MI6.
Is brought home to be analyzed, packaged up, and returned to the client, usually a government or private interest. How's that?
That doesn't sound very fun.
No, it sounds kind of boring.
Ask me again in 10 years and see if you still think it sounds boring.
I mean, then again, if she's out here supporting people, she's probably seen a lot of action.
I want to be a teacher, like Dad, and help people.
I can't even move her. This
you
blows.
You can do better than that.
What? Like you?
Oh.
What did you just say?
Ooh.
Nothing. I just want to go home.
What did he say? Damn, I missed it. Hold on. Reason with him.
Look, you've got your whole life ahead of you to figure out what you want to do when you grow up. I'm just trying to help you.
Fine. I don't want to talk about it anymore. I want to go home.
He hit her with that sass. She wasn't ready for it. What's that? Ooh. Someone's got info on. Oh, it's Spider. I bet it's Spider. That dude Spider got her. She's on. He's on you. I hope she get caught. I really do. I am working against her. I do not care. I'm going to work against her. I don't care. Let's see. Oh yeah, stranger danger.
The next station is Cobbett Square.
He's on to you. I know it. I know that spider. Stop.
Has he said anything?
Not a peep. He just sat there staring at us.
Do you think it would be weird if I asked Vivek out? It's always Becky and Vivek. I'm sick of this. I'm going out.
Is Becky your friend?
Bro, I feel like I'm watching a Play-Doh type TV show.
Ash, I need to get.
Oh yeah, Ash got snatched up by homie.
Stop a second. Mm-hmm. I can explain everything. Ah!
And now Emma's gonna be like, I haven't seen an Ash for like a minute. And I'm be like, I don't know. Dude with wings. Dude had eel wings for a moment, popped out of nowhere, snatched her up. Alright, what we rocking today? What we rocking today? I mean, she's darn skinned. So, some bright colors will work. Let's go with the yellow.
You got your date tonight, love?
Yeah. No idea where she's going to take me, though.
You never went on that date.
Yeah. Had enough of being single at this point. What are you both talking about?
Emma's taking a lovely girl out tonight.
I should probably get ready for work.
Oh, is this one she's meeting Ash for the first time? I want to know more.
Does this mystery woman have a name? Hazel.
Wait, huh?
Well, don't kiss Hazel on the first date. All right, that's enough.
How long has it been since Ash disappeared? Hold on, what's going on, Mom?
You doing okay, Mum?
I'm okay. I'm just going to have a little lie down. Don't think I've fully woken up yet.
You all right?
Of course, hon. Just one of my wobbles.
Okay, what was that? That's not a wobble. Mom's sick. Y'all need to take your mom to the hospital. Get her checked up. No run tonight?
So, Hazel, eh? Let's go for a walk. I need to talk to you about something.
How? Something's up.
Okay. I'm worried about Mum.
Really?
Oh, stop overreacting. She just lost her balance.
Come on, Donna. We both saw Mom trip on the doorstep. Like, what's going on?
We've both got to pull through for her.
She's sick. Good job.
Great pep talk. Donna, I mean it. I don't want to see you staying out with your friends all night anymore.
Double standards, this is bullshit, all night.
I'm not out all night. I'm not trying to have an argument. Please just promise you'll spend some time with Mum this evening.
Okay, now I'm seeing what Emma's always mad about. Their mom's getting sick. What's she hiding?
You're not telling me something. I think it's probably best you know what's going on.
Tell me then.
Well, don't leave me hanging.
Mom's sick, right?
Let's find somewhere quiet to talk.
What do you mean? Who's going to be paying attention to what we're talking about?
Mum's not well.
I could tell by the cough.
Oh, what? Like the flu or something? No. I mean, she's really not well. Oh. She's been having some tests and they've not come back great.
Ooh. Don't panic.
She'll be fine. Oh, you worry too much. I hope you're right.
Wrong boy. Mom's a machine. No worries. What's that?
Of course I am. When am I ever wrong? I'm gonna be late for work.
Wait, what about Ash? Is this before Ash or after Ash disappeared? Okay, this is after Ash disappeared. How long has it been since Ash disappeared?
There's no way that they could have survived the radiation in the spacesuits that they were wearing.
Did he make her legit disappear? Like, no one can remember her? No way.
It's just fact. Look it
up. This man just wiped her from everybody's memory.
Have you seen The Shining?
That's Donna, wild.
Hey.
What's poppin', G?
Hey. Not getting bored yet?
Yeah, I passed the time doing some spring cleaning. I managed to take down that old plastic sheet at the back of the pool.
School?
We need to sort out what we're doing here long term. I don't know how much more school I can miss.
Oh, yeah. Sure. We can talk about it when I come back tonight.
Where are you going? You and Becky go?
How was Moise's party? Becky said she was going.
The other night? Nah, I couldn't get away from Dad.
Nice, that makes it two of us.
Yeah, I didn't go either.
Oh. By the way, you should take some time to explore this place. There's an upstairs area at the back which is worth a look.
Wait, so this is our base operations now? Donna, do you like Vivek? I feel like she likes Vivek. Look, he knows it. Come on, man.
Fancy seeing what was behind that plastic sheet then?
Listen, Donna, we all know you like that, man.
How are you feeling today?
Strange question.
Fine, thank you.
That's good. You seemed a little unlike yourself the other night.
What do you mean by that? And he would know?
And you would know, right?
How's your sister?
She's got a date.
She seems okay. She's got a date tonight.
Interesting. She's not sad.
Yeah, because Ash is gone. What the hell are you talking about?
What? No, she's all right.
Where am I going? Okay, here we go. Bro, are we not going to talk about Ash? So Ash just disappeared. We don't care. Bro, he erased everyone's memory. That's got to be it. And he's just like, ooh, so y'all don't notice. Mm-hmm.
Oh, Viv.
Unnecessary.
Huh? Hold on, bro. Don't look at me like that. Say unnecessary like that.
That's my mom's favorite song.
It's lovely.
Didn't realize it was on here. Reminds me of her. It's been a while. Reminds me of her.
Always makes me think of her when I hear it.
What's wrong, Donna?
Just about mom.
Mom's ill. But it's fine. She'll be all right.
Why do you think that?
What? Why is there two whats? All right, this is what.
You are.
People are frail. If she's old, your mother will probably die.
Well, damn. Okay. Prick, wanker. Prick.
You prick.
Have I done something wrong?
Bro, you don't just tell someone that their parents is going to die like that, bro. All right, fun's over.
Vivek's going to be here soon. We should tie you back up.
Oh God, bro, you fucked up. I'm not getting any sign of friendship going on here,
bro. Look who's back.
Look like bro trying to flirt with me.
Hey.
You okay?
No, I'm not. You okay? Yep, sure, yeah, yep.
I'm fine.
Come on, let's go for a walk. I take it you weren't a fan of my attempts at interior decorating.
Oh, or walking. He did well, yeah. You should praise him.
No, I love that. It made me smile.
I figured if the three of us are spending more time here.
That reminds me.
Oh, yeah. Isn't Becky supposed to be here?
Dunno. Not heard from her since Moise's party.
What? Oh, really?
She told me she was going to ask you out. Probably shouldn't have said that.
She did, actually.
Ooh.
Oh.
Where the fuck am I going?
Why do you care about Becky asking me out? Is that why you're upset?
Worse than that, no.
No, it's something else.
I mean, I don't see why you'd care about who I went out with.
Hold on. That's all mom. You gonna tell him you like him?
Yes, you do care who I go out with.
Okay. You want to hear?
Hey, I'm trying to tell you something.
Sorry.
What's up? So Vivek likes Donna likes Vivek, but they ain't gonna say nothing. Hug.
Just give me a hug, yeah?
Oh my, okay. Okay, Donna, get your man! And then Becky gonna come around the corner, huh?
Wow.
Goofy Vic, surprise, doing all the work.
Leaving me to make the first move. What are you like?
Sorry. I wanted to for a while, but I didn't know if you liked
it. Listen, Donna get what she want, okay? Donna get what she want. Why not ask me, should have said, make up for lost time?
Well, maybe we can make up for lost time.
What do you mean?
Ooh, I want to stay here. I want him to stay. Keep me company.
I don't want to be alone tonight. Will you keep me company?
Hold on,
are you sure?
Are you sure, bro? What? Are you sure, man?
Yeah.
Bro says, are you sure? Like, Viv, you a walking L, bro. Bro, what's going on with this dude? What, are you jealous, bro? You're a grown-ass man, you need to relax. All right, paper dolls. Hold on.
Previously on Last Stop.
Did this grown man just get mad at a teenager trying to hook up with another teenager?
You've stolen my body!
We're both in exactly the same situation. There's got to be some cause, some connection between the two of us.
Oh yeah, Freaky Friday.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
It'll look too suspicious if I'm alone with Molly.
On Monday, see? We're gonna have to cover for each other. I'm gonna have to pretend to be you, and you're gonna have to pretend to be me.
Okay, so Paper Dolls is more like a Freaky Friday comedy type of thing. Stranger Danger is more like drama with a little bit of romance, while Domestic Affairs is more of a thriller mixed with a little bit of drama type thing going on. All right, what's the plan?
So what's the plan?
The only way this is going to work is if we imitate each other exactly. It's got to be perfect, right? So good that even my own mother wouldn't know the difference.
I doubt that. Moms know their kids. Jesus.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
Let him finish. This sounds fun.
First order of business, 7:30 a.m. Run with Amy. Amy's got a mind like clockwork. She is a stickler for punctuality. If you're even a minute late, she'll suspect something's up.
Oh,
right.
Come on.
And if I am, she'd automatically think I'm an imposter.
You don't know Amy.
Jack loves Amy.
I do not.
Moving on.
Can we get back to this, please?
Let's review the itinerary. 7:30 a.m. run with Amy. 7:50 visit coffee shop. 7:52 order skinny caramel macchiato, no foam. 7:53 consume beverage.
Okay. Flatten me, crush me, kill me, kill me.
7:55 put head in microwave.
8:15 buy Molly a new mobile phone.
Okay, now he's messing around.
Mm-hmm. All right, 7:24. Oh, I'm moving now. Okay.
So, I meet Amy. How do I explain what happened yesterday?
First, you'll have to put her completely at ease. She's a bit of a detective or something, so don't be
worried. Yeah, because she works for MI6. We all know this.
Just be super casual.
Something goes.
Okay. So, I just go up to her and say, "All right, love."
Pardon?
Damn it!
Dad, no.
Drumming into the 21st century, yeah? Look, just distract her somehow. Talk about something she loves.
We're out of cereal.
Cornflakes, I'll pick some after work.
Pick some up after work.
Focus. Look, Amy's a big theatre nerd. She could talk for hours about various plays she's into. It's incredibly boring. She's also been saying she fancies a holiday. Distract her with that.
Holiday, theatre, got it.
Okay. Holiday theater. Musicals?
So, seen any musicals lately?
What was the deal with that pisshead the other day? How come you're hanging out with fat middle-aged blokes?
Yo, what's going on? Forget
it. Him. Don't worry about that. But since you asked, he's actually a great guy. You know, salt of the earth type.
Just call me a fat...
So, are we going for
I should roundhouse kick you right now. Meat potatoes, thinking man.
He's a thinking man's man, you know? Got a lot about him. Got a lot to offer.
All right.
Keep up if you can.
Okay, I'm not doing it. Okay, I can actually run.
I feel great. I've not been able to run like this in years.
Okay, I'm not moving. I'm just pressing LB.
He spent enough time on the treadmill.
Sub-Zor, pretty vain. Sub-Zor.
Oh, I imagine I come across quite self-absorbed.
Well, you're no role model, but I wouldn't beat yourself up too bad.
Hold on, am I gonna end up with, tell me more.
What do you mean about me not being a good role model?
Enough with the chit-chat, you're giving me a stitch.
What the hell is chit-chat? I need to know.
Come on, let me hear it. What is it that makes me such a bad person?
Bad person? You're harmless, I just said you don't set a good example.
Yeah, that doesn't sound
good. You're just like me,
at all.
You're a total workaholic and a massive geek.
Massive geek.
Massive geek, not too bad. Yeah, I can live
Amy
with that.
Got a dumpy though. That's that's all the motivation I need. Yes, sir.
That was great. I feel fantastic. So, when can we do this again?
On my shoulders.
What's going on with you? You all right?
I'm just having a good time. I feel great.
What do you mean? I've never felt better. I'll call you tomorrow.
No, it's fine. I'll call you. Take care of yourself, okay, Jack?
Oh, does she got a crush on Jack?
Better get our story straight for Shaz.
Shaz is great. You're going to love her.
Hang on, what do you mean story?
We're related? Oh, I made up something up. My car was related.
Well, you may be surprised to learn. It turns out you and me are related.
Huh?
Welcome to the family, Jack.
I fucking love it, Molly. Meet Dad Jack. A lot of Chaz. John, you have a crush on Chaz. I knew it. Ooh. Listen, I'm picking up on these. I'm on my B's and Q's when it comes to these things.
Oh, it's you. I was just talking to John about his mysterious nephew.
All right, lad.
You know, I don't tell you this nearly enough, but you are definitely the handsome one in the family.
Oh my God. Careful, Jack.
That's unlike you, John. To give out compliments like that, it's just not your usual style.
So, now your family secret's out, I'm dying to know more. What was it like
having John as an uncle? Let's ham it up, can't complain. Can't complain.
You know, John, a total gent. Always has been.
That's kind of you to say, Jack.
Mm-hmm.
I would only add that it was made easier by you being such a kind, considerate, patient, intelligent, handsome young man.
Oh my God.
Jack in town for?
Oh, not long.
For the foreseeable.
Just a few days, really.
He's staying, he's kidding.
He's only joking.
I'm actually not.
Sounds like you both need to get your stories straight. Where were you before you came to London, Jack?
Damn, fucking up. Here and there.
Just here and there.
He was in Cambodia.
Wow, Cambodia.
Ooh.
Yeah, he's working for the UN. You know, peacekeeping, noble stuff.
Bro, stop.
Not that glamorous, really. Mainly just cleaning toilets and making coffee.
He's done well for himself. Now he runs this high-tech startup you see selling solar-powered submarines to the super rich.
Oh my God, bro, you're fucking it up.
Well, that all sounds fascinating. I hope life isn't too slow-paced for you while you slum it with us.
God, Jack, you done blew it! You blew it! Damn, my man's recovered that.
Well, I'm gonna head off, John. Don't be too late.
Cheerio.
See you later.
I'm pretty sure she caught on.
She's nice.
Submarines.
Too much?
Way too
so
much,
what
bro.
Is it that you
work
at
a
anyway?
Goddamn game
Are
company.
A taxidermist.
A taxidermist? No, I'm a creative. I work in design. I'm an artist.
Taxidermists are people who take animals and pull out their insides and make them stand up and things. It's awesome.
Molly, we gotta take away your phone for a little bit. All right. Jack, the artist.
You don't look like an artist.
Yeah, well, not anymore, I don't, do I? But that's my job. I'm a video game developer.
Yeah, I told you.
That's so cool.
Exactly.
Thanks. Yeah, not traditional games like shooters or RPGs or free-to-play stuff. My team makes empathy games.
Empathy games?
It's art, really. You know, games which say something about the human condition. Cutting-edge stuff.
Hmm. Oh, boy. Okay.
Uh-huh.
I played this game where you had to run really fast over a road. Only I didn't, and I got hit by a train. I died.
Hold on, what's she talking about? The cardball one, that one on the island, the maze one? Is it the maze one?
There's one we have at work on a screensaver where you navigate through a maze. Did you do that one?
No. That wasn't me.
Oh my God, John,
you
sound old.
Train?
No. No, I didn't. Sorry.
You should have been a taxidermist.
Molly's talking. Okay, Molly, you throw a little bit of shade. You throw a little shade, all right? I ain't changed my clothes, though.
Super fab. It's not far from your office, actually.
Sounds easy. Wait. This is a real job?
People pay you to do this?
Yeah. Some people say game makers are the new rock stars.
Dad, can you put me in one of Jack's video games?
Maybe I can.
Put Molly in your game, Jack. Is that even possible?
Let's just try to get through the first day to begin with, yeah?
Right.
I'll walk you through.
How is he going to get through it? That's
Don't
a lot of
forget,
coding to do.
I need to be taken to school at some point.
Exactly.
Yeah. Now, first you need to find my desk. You can't miss it. It's the one with the robot doing the sick dab. Sneak past Sonia, the receptionist. Avoid any awkward questions.
Fine.
She's a bit dippy, so you shouldn't have any problems there.
Aww. All right.
All right. Well, no need to be horrible. She sounded nice enough on the phone.
Right, ain't
You're
she fine?
Mean, Jack.
Right.
How old are you anyway?
8 and a half.
Good age.
Why?
Dunno.
Hold on, Jack, what do you mean by that, bro? You trying to get punched in the jawline? Hold on, bro, back off my daughter. Alright, Jalen, you look hella suspicious. Sneak back Sonya? Why am I sneaking past? I'm trying to holler at Sonya. How you doing? How's your day been? You been feeling all right? Oh, I gotta hold it. Okay, hold it. Okay. Okay, a little extra, but it's all right. There's no way she doesn't see his big ass head. Bro, this is a comedy. I'm running out of fingers. Oh my God, John.
Hello, stranger.
What's up, Sonya? How you doing today? You trying to get a coffee? Arrested. Listen, I just try to, you know, be nice.
Thanks. You do too?
Thanks.
Oh my God, I
believe. Get in there, Jack, my son. Good morning!
Wait, did you slap my butt?
In a good mood.
Must be one of Jack's mates. I don't know.
Right, Derek. Yeah, the office clown.
I wouldn't tell him that. He'll have you fired.
Damn, he's the boss. Ooh.
He's my boss?
Yeah.
Come on, John. Hey, why are you sitting with a
You never
question?
Told me how your holiday was.
Listen, it was sad because you weren't there. Very spiritual, hot.
Oh. Warm. Balmy. Great sunbathing weather. You should see my tan.
In Iceland.
Okay, well,
God
I've got to run.
It.
Keep on keeping on.
Bye.
I'm blowing it.
What do I do
I
when I get
there?
I ain't
never getting a date.
It's Monday. That means sprint planning. You're going to coordinate with your team on their tasks for the week.
That's no good with stuff like that.
Oh, God.
Molly's right. I don't think anyone would follow me into battle.
It's simple, trust me. Jonah's working on modelling the last of the cream cakes for Mrs. Clapton's tea shop.
Mrs. Clapton? Oh my God.
Time and home scene with the shell shock veteran.
Okay.
Tobias is writing up the design for the interactive funeral procession.
Ooh.
And Meyer is midway through implementing rumble support.
Damn.
And this is a computer game.
Video game.
Your game sounds bad, Jack.
Ow,
is
Molly?
Is embodying the experience of someone who's witnessed death and is coming to terms with their own mortality? It's poetic.
Yo, that game sounds sad.
Jonah cakes, Letitia shell shock, Tobias funerals, Maya rumble.
See? You're a natural.
Wow.
Hello.
Oh my God, I gotta do it myself? Oh,
good
my
weekends,
God.
Everyone?
Get
up to anything interesting? No. Okay, let's see. So, I'm supposed to go around everyone and check what you're all working on. So, Jonah.
Fuck! Wait. Jonah, cakes.
You are modelling cream cakes, aren't you? I'll take the silence as an agreement. Okay, Letitia.
No one has a face. Letitia, what's she doing? Retirement homes?
With AI. No, IA. For retirement homes. Yeah, sounds right. Okay, Tobias.
No, I did it wrong. Fuck!
Actually, I'm not sure that's right. And finally, Maya.
She's doing the rumbling. She... No!
God!
I pressed B! I pressed B!
Sorry,
fuck!
Look. Even I can tell this meeting is a bit pointless. You all know what you're up to, even if I don't.
God.
I guess what you're really looking for is a pep talk, isn't it? Some words of encouragement.
Bro, they ain't saying that because they don't got no faces.
I'm sorry. I thought I could do this, but... None of this comes naturally to me. You all look like nice, bright people. You don't need to listen to an old fart like me. I'm sorry that I can't give you anything more inspiring. Maybe I'll just leave you with the advice that my dad gave to me on my 18th birthday.
Okay.
Keep your head down. Don't take unnecessary risks. Stay out of debt.
That sounds like a sucky pep talk, bro.
Cheers.
I feel
Come
sad.
Come on, baby. Don't tell me now. Give me that Derek loving.
Oh my
yes,
God.
Yes, yes!
Oh my God. Derek, you need to relax, bro. Ooh, I have no idea what I'm doing. I'm John. Damn, you tapping that keyboard kind of tough. Try again. Bro, why are you tapping it so hard? Bro, about to break his keyboard. I think it's broke, Jack. Okay. I am Mrs. Clapton, the cream tea guru. Would you like to purchase one of my freshly baked cakes? Today's specials are salted mint and Himalayan lemon cheesecake, bubblegum shortbread served with whipped sour oat milk, and bow hunted elk. Oh, all right, fuck me. I read too slow. I'm sorry.
This is ridiculous. What the hell?
Why'd I get shot in the head? What the fuck going on? Is that Derek?
Headshot.
Come on, Jack. Let's have our catch up.
Okay.
Who the fuck? Who shoots their employee in the head with a damn Nerf gun? If we weren't close, I'd punch you in the head. Nah, I won't. I ain't trying to lose my job. This man John walk like he said.
Jack, I'm loving that TV series you recommended. Did you catch the latest episode? What did you think of the chapel scene?
This man ain't doing nothing. He's chilling. That's a boss right there. good?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, I'm glad you're enjoying it. That the Lord forgives, I do not bit. And then he pulled out the machine gun and was all... blew that bugger's chin clean off.
Who is this old man? Man, good grief.
It's, one for the archives.
Jack, I'll cut right to it. Your team is doing fantastic work. Really outstanding. But the publisher's over next month. Surprise visit, you know how these things go.
All right, be positive.
Sounds exciting.
It'll be a shit show. I need you and your guys to crunch for the next few weeks. Obviously, we'll take care of pizzas, takeaway, whatever you guys need.
You mean work overtime?
It'll be good fun, won't it? The team hard at it, down in the trenches together.
No, bro, I'm trying to go home. Is this CD? Am I in CD Projekt Red?
Free up the next few weekends.
Oh, nah. So we'll keep any 7-day stints to a minimum. If you could have your boys free up the next few weekends, nah, bro, I got plans.
But no thanks. I've got plans. Sorry,
Jack. The company expects it of you, and you don't want
to
let.
No, bro, you're asking us to work 7 days.
I mean, I'd love the overtime pay. Don't get me wrong, but
bit.
I can't give up that time right now.
Overtime pay? You're getting a little off message, Jack. As a line manager, I need you to set an example.
No overtime pay? Oh, you must be tripping. This is ridiculous.
We make games. We're not saving lives here. What do I get out of this?
Don't raise your voice to me. I expect the team to pull together, to show some passion.
And come down here in the trenches with us. What you mean?
Passion? I'll show you what you can do with your passion.
Tell him, John. And I got fired, didn't I?
Hey, Dad!
Oh. Hey, John.
So, listen, bro. We got fired. I don't know
Dad,
what happened. I was doing a great job.
Tell you.
Yeah. Now, before I go into details, it's important you know that a lot of your colleagues were really impressed with how I handled things today.
Jack got fired.
Tell me she's joking.
No. I didn't get fired. Molly, don't tell your dad that. Okay, well, maybe I had to get a little bit fired.
Yep, you got fired too.
Between you and me, I think that Clive fella overstepped his authority. I mean, I was just trying to give him some friendly advice.
Right. We're screwed.
This is a disaster.
It's all good. We still got my job, and no offense, but it pays better too. I'll sort your pay slip.
We got fired too.
Uh-oh.
Everything okay? Something go wrong?
Bro, I got fired, bro. Bro, I was trying to make me work 7 days a week. No overtime pay? Nah. Tea?
I'll put the kettle on.
Wait.
What? You got fired as well? Pretty eventful day, right?
Oh, this is not happening. What a nightmare.
Oh, but it was all gravy when you lost my job.
Do you two need some privacy?
Very cute.
Okay, that's it. Okay. I'm going to demolish a cheesecake. Who wants some?
I want 2 slices.
Hey, it's my figure you're ruining there. But yeah, I'll have a quarter.
A quarter? Mm-hmm. You'll get what's left, mate.
God, man. Okay, I both their bosses was dickheads though. Okay, so they both did each other a good favor. I ain't gonna lie. Okay, so they're all wearing the fits I chose. Okay, I just wish she had a better fit. Like, God. Okay, Donna. Okay, so let's do a little quick recap. I can't zoom in because I lost my damn zoom in thing. I was about to go click it. But anyway, so look. Okay, Paper Dolls. John and Jack are now fired, but they both stood up to the bosses. Well, they switched over though. Mina, her son's catching on to her cheating. I made her block Felix because we don't do cheaters here. She can bump that. And now Donna, she's actually doing the best at all. She got her man. I mean, her sister, Ash has disappeared. Dude erased her from existence, put her in the house. But her mom's dying though. I mean, she's not dying, but she's sick though. But it looks like the dude might be able to help her. But as y'all saw at the ending, dude was looking a little kind of mad. But it's like, bro, you're a grown man trying to get with a little girl. She's in high school, bro. What you doing? Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And don't forget to ring that bell button. I'll see you guys in the next one.